Recognize that guy? One of the original chefs from Pizza Hut back in the day. I'm at Potter & Potter in the Belmont Craig neighborhood. I'm Tom Barnes, the Chicago scene, checking out some vintage items like these old slot machines. Look at this, very cool thing. I'm gonna talk to Gabe, who's the owner who started this company back on his coffee table with his dad. And now he's got this giant, massive footprint here in the Belmont Craig neighborhood. We're gonna see what they're auctioning off and how you can sell your stuff now on the Chicago scene. Potter & Potter auctions since 2007, but this is a newer space, and I'm here with owner and founder Gabe. How are you, sir?
I'm great, Tom. How are you?
I'm great. So, you guys, we first met years ago at the Houdini auction,
right, and that's
kind of where things started for you guys as far as, I mean, I know you said started off on a coffee table with your dad, right? And then that was back in 2007.
Right.
And you've since gone on to other things, including this new space here. So just talk about your auction house and what you guys focus on and all that good stuff.
We are a collectibles, antiques, book, and fine art auction house here in Chicago. We're on the west side. And we just moved into this new location in January. And we've grown from that coffee table to this 15,000 square foot building. And as opposed to me making a catalog kind of crouched over that coffee table, there's a whole staff back there making 16 or more auctions a year, big beautiful catalogs. We're selling slot machines and comic books and autographs and rock and roll memorabilia. And still to this day, we're well known for the Houdini memorabilia and the vintage magic posters and tricks that we auction almost every other month.
And that's kind of, you guys are like the biggest magic auction house in the world, right? At least that's what your dad told me.
I would say we're...
or one of the biggest. How
that's
about that?
Like saying, you know, to your only child that you're my favorite son. You know, we are the only magic auction house in the world that I'm aware of that at least does public auctions. There's some people who run them online. But we've really become the go-to source for that kind of material. But ever since we started the business, we've, you know, looked outside that world. That was something I was interested in as a kid. Mm-hmm. And now here we are, you know, with a whole variety of merchandise. We actually sell a lot more things that aren't related to magic, although we're never going to forget our roots.
Sure.
But we've really expanded our scope, especially in the last 5 years, just tremendously.
I know we were walking through the space here and you have some real amazing artwork, particularly that poster in the back there, the Illinois poster, celebrating a centennial of some kind, all the way to concert memorabilia. I saw a James Brown poster back there.
Yeah, yeah.
And you have a really interesting one that you guys have coming up with Disney World or Disneyland or
just Disney. Well, all of those. It's you know, Disneyland, Disney World, it's all of the parks, really, California Adventure, everything. We've got Mickey Mouse, we've got like pieces of rides that we'll be selling in the auction, Walt Disney autographs, and then the second day of that auction will be pop culture memorabilia, so that'll include guitar signed by the Rolling Stones, and it'll include album covers and artwork, you know, that's autographed by everyone from Tom Petty to Jefferson Airplane, Beatles memorabilia, so, you know, every month.
To some, priceless works of art to some people.
To some, I mean, beauty's in the eye beholder, but
sure.
To some priceless works of art. And occasionally we sell works of art that you can put a price on. Last week, paintings from Tim Storyer, the Australian artist, and Norman Rockwell posters, just a whole variety of rare and unusual objects.
Well, then you have the books. I mean, you're showing me a Moby Dick first edition book.
Right.
I mean, that's incredible. That is history right in your hands.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And one of a few really choice things coming up in August. He has first editions of many of the great, you know, works in literature coming up in the August sale. Earlier this year, we were offering letters from Einstein, from James Baldwin, Audubon's. The book market for us has really developed tremendously.
Yeah, even Catcher in the Rye we saw, which
right.
is one of my favorite books of all time. So
oh,
it's
really?
Just super cool to see. And then it brings us to the space that we're in now where you have a few things. You have some stuff that's coming up, which is behind me. You have like some circus stuff. Is that what you said earlier?
So this weekend, May 29th, Memorial Day weekend, we have coin-op and advertising at auction. So we have vintage arcade games, vintage slot machines, vintage jukeboxes.
So that's what this is.
Yeah, so
this over here.
Beautiful scale. You know, that's a mutoscope machine on the right there.
A what scope?
It's called a mutoscope.
Okay.
So that would have been an early way of almost not quite going to the movies, but as you crank handle.
And you look inside.
The light goes on and you see the picture show.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then there was the jukebox here.
Perfect for your home man cave.
Yeah.
Space Invaders, you can relive the 80s with all your friends.
And then some classic stuff here.
Yeah, that's a peep show, a 5 cent peep show viewer. And of course, you don't really see what they're promoting on the outside. It's a bit of a gag when the light goes on. You get a little laugh. You don't really get to see any falsehoods.
Yes, because this is probably from what years?
It's probably from the 50s. That was made by Exhibit Supply in Chicago.
Got it. And then you have, looks like a fun scale here.
Beautiful deco scale.
But this is super cool. This I've never seen before, a two-headed cow.
Yeah.
Right?
So that's a two-headed calf, and every year we do an auction of circus, sideshow, and oddities memorabilia. Mm-hmm. You can decide which category that one falls into. that's a devil child gaff that would have been on a sideshow, so you would have paid 10 cents to go see the little devil child.
Oh, wow.
And then next to him is the head of his big brother, which is a magic trick that he looks around and then finds your chosen card.
Then some of the games right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, so
right?
we display multiple auctions, you know, at the same time. So we've got some slot machines, a lot of which were made in Chicago.
Yes, that's what we did an around town actually about this. And these are the more slot machines.
More slots.
That are up for the auction this particular weekend.
So
but this is air after it, but either way, this is an example of what you guys
something do. Something we do on an ongoing basis, absolutely. So from, you know, vintage soda advertising to, you know, that was in our vintage poster auction. We, you know, do a couple of those a year. Vintage gas and oil sign there. The ripoff of James Montgomery flag there. That's coming up in our June magic auction. That's actually a poster for a theater from London. That was their most famous attraction there.
And what is this?
Here's Laughing Sal. This is a recreation by a very talented friend of mine. It's a coin-operated arcade machine that's famous. And if you could find an original, it'd be $30,000-$40,000. So Mike has created them in, and they're coin-operated. You put a nickel in and off it goes.
And this is the actual, this is where people will, when things are safe to come back, if not already.
Yeah, depending. If you're vaccinated or you wear a mask, we're happy to have you come in limited numbers. And we're happy to welcome people into auctions. Of course, a lot of people participate online now. We stream everything live on our website, so you can sit at home in your bunny slippers and your robe and drink a cup of coffee and watch me call the auction and tell the same five jokes every
Are you
auction.
Doing the auction?
Yeah.
Are you doing do you do it real fast and repeated? Give me an example. Let's hear.
Tom, we're going to start Tom at a modest $5 opening bid.
$5. Well, that's
$5. Yep. Will anyone give me six? Six. I'm six. I have six.
My mom.
I have six. Thank you, Tom's mom. We're looking for seven.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
I think I recognize that guy back there. Is that from a bar or is that from, what's that from?
Pizza Hut.
That's from Pizza Hut?
From a long time ago.
Oh, man. I thought it was like from Gene's Sausage Shop or something like that. That's what I remember.
You can buy it and donate it to Gene's Sausage Shop.
Oh, sure, sure.
Yeah, that's the old Pizza Hut chef.
And he also had some stuff from Riverview, which we saw
earlier. Yeah, we saw a side of a caterpillar ride that'll be in the circus and sideshow and carnival auction.
And then something like this. Where is this from?
That is a Space Patrol, also made by Mike Kazanov.
Oh,
and,
very cool.
Coin-op restorations. It is, you know, find an original and you won't be able to. So this is cherry mint, brand new, the best you can get.
So for people who want to, maybe somebody has something in their attic that they think that might be worth something.
Mm-hmm.
How do they go about trying to get their stuff here at auction?
We get calls every day. We get emails every day. Best way to do it is to drop us a line, send us photos, or give us a call. We travel all over the world to pick up collections. We filled up shipping containers in Germany and France. And we've been to basements in Bolingbrook. So, I mean, we're really wherever the merchandise takes us is where we'll go. But a little preview sent us in advance will tell us whether or not it's a good fit for us, or maybe we can recommend you to someone else. We don't sell furniture or jewelry or glass, unless it has maybe some historic association or something like
unless
that.
Unless it's a Houdini's bathtub.
Right, or in July we're selling Frank Sinatra's music stand, or you know, things from Barbara Streisand's house, things like that.
What's the website?
PotterAuctions.com.
Gabe, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Let me take a look around, stroll down memory lane of yesteryear and even mine from the 80s. I appreciate it. Thanks.
Yeah, thanks, Tom.
No problem. All right, there you have it. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. That's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, until then, good luck at the old auction thing, right?